We are doing sequence of functions. So I hope you all know the meaning of pointwise convergence, uniform convergence. So let me take an example. Number one, for each natural number n, let fn be a function from R to R defined by this fnx is sine nx over n. This was the question which sir had done graphically, right? But the graphs are so interesting. So the question is, prove that this series sequence FN converges uniformly on R. Okay. So see, this is the question. This is the sequence of functions, that f1x is sine x by 1, f2x is sine 2x by 2, and so on, right? So before proving that it is uniformly convergent, you have to first prove that this convergence pointwise on R. You always remember that I cannot talk about the uniform convergence unless I talk about the pointwise convergence. Getting my point? So can you tell me what was the pointwise limit here? What was the pointwise limit here? You all have done. Where will this sequence of function converge pointwise? See, whenever we are talking about pointwise limit, we fix the value of x, you know that? We fix the value of x and then we find the limit n tends to infinity. That is what we are trying to find for the pointwise limit. So, my point is, for each x from the domain, what is this limit? Limit n tends to infinity fnx, that is sine nx over n. Now this is 0 since sine nx is a bounded function which is less or equals to 1, and then we are remaining with limit n tends to infinity 1 by n. So this is nothing but 0. So this 1 by n goes to 0 and this is bounded, so this limit will be 0. Got my point or no? See, are you understanding the meaning of pointwise limit or no? Be frank. If you have a confusion, I can clear the doubt. Clear to everyone? No. Okay. So, okay. Let me start with easy examples then. Let me start with easy examples then. So I'll keep a space here. I don't know how much space I need for this sum. Okay, let me take 1.5 pages. Let me give you another example. Number 2. So number 2 is this. Let me write the question properly. For each n over n, define एफ एन फ्रॉम 0 इन्फिनिटी अप टू आर. सो दिस इज द सीक्वेंस ऑफ फंक्शन बाय, व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ दिस एफ एन, एफ एन एक्स इज दिस वन एक्स बाई एन, एक्स बाई एन एक्स ओवर, सॉरी द डोमेन हेयर इज आर ओनली. आई टेक अनदर एग्जाम्पल वेर आई टेक दैट वन, एक्स बाई एन फॉर ऑल एक्स इन आर. सो लुक एट दिस क्वेश्चन, यू सी वॉट इज एफ वन एक्स, एफ वन एक्स इज एक्स बाई वन. वॉट इज एफ टू एक्स, इट इज एक्स बाई टू. वॉट इज एफ थ्री एक्स, इट इज दिस फंक्शन एक्स बाई थ्री एंड सो ऑन, राइट. सो एफ वन इज अ फंक्शन फ्रॉम आर टू आर डिफाइंड बाई एक्स मैप टू एक्स. एफ टू इज अ फंक्शन फ्रॉम आर टू आर डिफाइंड फ्रॉम एक्स एक्स मैप टू एक्स बाई टू. एफ थ्री इज अ फंक्शन फ्रॉम आर टू आर डिफाइंड बाई एक्स मैप टू एक्स बाई थ्री. सो दिस इज अ infinite sequence of function. Now what do you mean by point wise limit? You see, you choose any point from the domain. Let me take one by one, okay. I'm being very calculative here. Choose any point from here. You tell me a point. Let me start with the easiest point in R, 0. Tell me what will be this function, what will be f1 at 0. What will be f1 at 0? Zero. What will be f2 at 0? What will be f3 at 0? Again 0 and so on. Do you see? I am evaluating the values of this functions at one point, suppose 0. Where is this sequence converging? Where is this sequence converging? This converges to 0. Right or no? Now you see, take another point. This is for x equals to 0. For x equals to 0. Now take for x equals to 1. Tell me what is f1x at 1? Very good. What is f2x at 1? It is half, right? Next one will be 1/3. Next one will be 1/4 and so on. Is this a convergent sequence? Now this is a question of real sequence. Tell me, is this a convergent sequence? Is this a convergent sequence? I'm waiting for your answer. Definitely it is a convergent sequence. You see why? What is the nth term of this sequence? What will be fnx at 1? What will be fnx at 1? What will be fnx at 1? It will be 1 by n. So nth term is 1 by n. So what is limit? Limit n tends to infinity 1 by n, which will be nothing but 0, you know. So this converges to 0. Are you getting my point? Did you understand this part? Yes. Take for any other point. For x equals to 9.5. For x equals to 9.5. What is f1x? What is f1x? Be quick. What is f1x at 9.5? 9.5. What about f2x? 9.5 by 2. Then 9.5 by 3 And what is the nth term? 9.5 by n and so on. Is this a convergent sequence? Is this a convergent sequence? It converges to zero due to the same fact, because limit n tends to infinity, right? 9.5 by n will definitely go to zero. So again, this converges to zero. So what I am seeing, whatever x you give me here, this is going to be zero always. Getting my point? Right? So for each x over r, as I am seeing, for 0 it is going to 0, for 1 it is going to 0. So I'll write in general, you don't have to write this much. I'll simply write for each x over r, this limit we are seeing, calculating, you see, n tends to infinity fn x, we are calculating this limit. So what is this limit? This limit is nothing but limit n tends to infinity x by n. Remember, right? This limit will always go to 0, because x is a constant. Whenever you are taking x from r, that is becoming a constant that can be taken outside the limit, and limit 1 by n will be 0. So whatever x you choose, this limit is going to be 0. Are you getting my point? Yeah. That means you see, we say that this sequence of function converges point wise to r. That means whatever point you give me, that function, see, when I'm putting 0, this is becoming a real sequence. So we are talking about the convergence of real sequence now. We are checking at every point. So I can define the limit function. We call this as a limit function. So I am defining function like this. Define f from r to r. Why I am choosing here r? Because the function converges at every point in the domain. Define f from r to r by f of x is 0 for all x over r. This function f is called the limit function. See, this will give you the answer directly. We are constructing a function. If I put here 0, what is the answer? 0. That means the sequence of function converges to 0 at 0. When I am giving you 9.5, what is the answer given by this function? 0. That means the sequence of function converges to 0 at the point 9.5. So we are constructing a function which will give you the limits. This function is nothing but limit at everything. This fx is nothing but this. Limit n tends to infinity fn x. This is how we define this function. Understood? This will give you the directly the limit. Very good. I'll give you another example. So we write like this, fn converges to f, and here we can write point wise also. I hope this symbol, sir, is using point wise. So what is the advantage of this calculating this limit function? Now you can clearly say at what points the function converges and to which value. So let me give you another example to be more clear about it. Yes, take this example, that will be much interesting. Example number 3. For each natural number, we are defining like this. Define fn from R to R. No, where the domain they have taken is 0 infinity. Okay. Define fn from 0 infinity, that is the positive 1 up to R by this one. Fn x is nx by 1 plus nx. And definitely the domain is this. Find the limit function. Find the limit function. This is the function. You can guess what is f1x. F1x is x by 1 plus x. F2x is 2x by 1 plus 2x. F3x is 3x by 1 plus 3x and so on. So domain is this. We can choose points from here and we'll see at which points they converge. So let me again do some calculations. For x equals to 0, what is this sequence? What is the sequence? The sequence is, the sequence is what? At 0, what is f1x? At 0, what is f1x? When I'm talking about f1x, n is 1. So f1x is x by 1 plus x. So what is f1x? 0 by 1 plus 0, which is 0. What is f2x? What is f2x? So what is the definition of f2x? 2x by 1 plus 2x. Very good. 2x by 1 plus 2x. That is again 0. Then 0. You may check. So which converges to? Which converges to 0. So at 0, all of these functions converge to 0. At the point 0 from the domain, they all converge to 0. Next, take another point. Suppose at x equals to 1. Let's see. I'm just doing like this. Okay. In general, I'm going to do later on. So what is the sequence at 1? So f1x, n is 1. So it is x by 1 plus x. Right? It is going to be half. Right? For f1x, n is 1. So x by 1 plus x, I am putting 1. So it is 1 by 1 plus 1. That is half. Right? Can you tell me what is f2x? F2x at 1. By 3. Very good. Next, 3 by 4 and so on. Is this a convergent sequence? Is this a convergent sequence? See, how do I know this is a convergent sequence? First, you write down the nth term of this one. What is the nth term? So, fn x at 1. So, n by 1 plus n. So, the nth term is this. Nth term is this. So limit, I'm doing like this. I'm finding this. Fn at 1. So this is limit n tends to infinity. Fn at 1 is nothing but n by 1 plus n, right? Because this was f1 at 1. This is f2 at 1. This is f3 at 1. So to check whether this is convergent or no, you have to find this limit. Limit n tends to infinity, fn at 1. Tell me, how will you evaluate this limit? Dividing by n, you all know. So if I divide by the highest power of n, which is 1, so this will become 1 by n plus 1, right? What is this limit? What is this limit? 1. Very good, because this goes to 0. So 1 by 0 plus 1, which is 1. So this converges to 1. Now you see, very interestingly, at 0, this sequence of functions converges to 0. But at 1, they are converging to some other point 1. Let me check for another number. Tell me any other another number from the domain, definitely. You can take any number. I'm just giving you a try, okay? So what is this? X equals to, suppose I'm taking 5 this time. The sequence is, so what is the sequence? So instead of writing this sequence, forget about this, we'll directly find where the sequence converges. That means I want to check this. Yes or no? I want to check this. I'm checking at 5. Right? So now you see, did you understand this? Yeah. So this is what? Limit n tends to infinity. What is fn x at 5? This is 5n by 1 plus 5n. 5n by 1 plus 5n. Where will this converge? That is your task. Can you tell me? Be quick. Is it? Be sure, just check it once. Yes, Rashmi is correct. It should be 1. The answer lies here. You can divide by 5n. You can divide by 5n. So this will become 1 by 5n. Plus 1. Where will this go, Raj Kamal? This goes to 0. So 1 by 0 plus 1. That will become 1 by 1, which is 1. Even if you are dividing by n, that will also work. You see, if you are dividing by n, what you are getting? 5 by 1 by n plus 5. Right? Where will this go? This goes to 0. But you are getting with 5 by 5. Which is again 1. It is not necessary that you have to divide by 5n. Okay, even if you are dividing by n, this 5 by 5 is again 1. So, can you make a guess? What is my point? At 0, it is going to 0 for sure, as you can see that. But now my guess is, at every other point, it always goes to 1. So how will I prove this? I cannot check for every number. 1, 5, 10, 11. I cannot check for every number. What is my thing is, my guess is, whenever I am taking any number which is not equals to 0, whenever I am taking a number from the domain, but not equals to 0, okay, then what is this limit? Limit n tends to infinity fn x. Here the number is x, which is limit n tends to infinity nx by 1 plus nx. You can take this x outside. Limit n tends to infinity n by 1 plus nx. You divide by n. Limit n tends to infinity. If I'm dividing by n, I'm getting 1 by n plus x. This limit is 1 over x because this goes to 0. X and x cancel is 1. Are you getting my point? So at every other point except 0, the functions will converge to 1. At 1, at 5, at 7, at 9.2, at 9.99, everything the function will converge to 1. Now, Why I cannot do the same thing for 0 also? Why I cannot do, where will I stuck? If I take for 0 also, here. See, for 0 we are getting 0 like this. Right? But my question is, even if I am not taking this condition, I am just assuming that for x over the domain, I can do in the same way. But where will I stuck? Very good. You cannot cancel this x and x. Here I am assuming that x is not 0. So I am cancelling this. if x would have been 0, I cannot cancel x and x. So here I am assuming the condition that x is not 0, that is the reason I took here x not equals to 0. So at any other point, the function converges to 1, but this does not guarantees you about the point 0. We are unsure where will the function converge at 0. So for 0, we have to do a different case like this. For 0, I have obtained the sequence which converges to 0. So doing this much is not required. I'll just do this one for 0 and this one in general. So define a function from the domain to R by, so this function is the limit function, that means it is this one, limit n tends to infinity fn x. So this limit is 0 if x equals to 0, this is 1 if x not equals to 0. So this is the limit function in this case. The function converges to 0 at 0, and at any other point the function converges to 1. Fn converges to f pointwise, and this f is known as the limit function. Understood? So now you have a basic idea what do you mean by limit function and what do you mean by pointwise convergence. So this function converges pointwise to this function. That means at 0, the sequence of function converges to 0. At any other point, the sequence of function converges to 1. Clear? So do you have any confusion? No, right? So then you are going to do a sum for me. Now I'll give you a sequence of function and you tell me the pointwise limit of that function, or the limit function of that function. So this was question number. So today I'll not discuss anymore about uniform convergence. I'll only talk about this one, pointwise convergence. You have to solve some limits for each natural number. Define fn's from R to R by fn x equals to, again there, okay, I'll take another example there. Fn x equals to, just a minute, okay. X by 1 plus, this is not required, you can do it by yourself then. Achha, x by 1 plus nx. Or I could have taken, do this. nx by 1 plus n square x square. 1 plus n square x square. X over r. So the function is fnx is nx by 1 plus n square plus x square. Okay? Find the limit function. Do it. That means you tell me for every x over r, where will the function converge pointwise. Let me also give it a try. So how will I do it? Sir, only 0. Sir, 0 only. Okay, very good. So we'll first find for 0. We'll in most of the cases we treat 0 differently. Right? So for x equals to 0, the sequence is 0, 0, 0 and so on, which converges to 0. Right? Done. For 0, the sequence of function converges to 0. For any other point not equals to 0, for x not equals to 0, negative, positive, we don't care. Let's compute this limit n tends to infinity fn x. This is nothing but limit n tends to infinity nx by 1 plus n square x square. This is x goes outside, limit n tends to infinity. Remember, why can x go outside? Because x is a constant, only n is the variable here. x is fixed. Now dividing by the highest power of n, the highest power of n being 2, dividing by n square. So n by n square will be 1 by n, and this is 1 by n square, and this is x, right? So this is nothing but x. This is 0, this is 0 by x, remember this is 0 by x, right? As n tends to infinity, this is 0 by x. Because x not equal to 0, that whole thing is 0. That whole thing is 0. You cannot cancel x this time because this converges to 0. This is 0 by x and x not equal to 0. So 0 by any number not equal to 0 will be 0, and x into 0 is 0. So therefore, for 0 also it is converging to 0. For not 0 also it is converging to 0. So therefore, this function f from R to R defined by f of x is nothing but 0 for x so fn converges to f pointwise. So this is how we find the limit function. So now you tell me, for this case, what will be the limit function? Do you agree with me? Now you tell me, look at this case and tell me, do you agree with me or no? See, whatever x I pick, this cannot go beyond 1. You know, the modulus of sine nx, the highest value is 1. So whatever x you choose, 0, 5, 100, 200, 1.5, this cannot exceed 1. So this is a number less or equals to 1. So this is somewhat like 1 by n. So where will 1 by n go to? 0. You can also use sandwich theorem here. Sine nx by n is always greater or equals to 0. Modulus, right? Because it can be negative also. So if I'm using modulus, and this will be less or equals to 1 by n, because this is always less or equals to 1. So now you see, this goes to 0, so this will go to 0, right? So in other ways also you can clearly see, because this is bounded, so this is, and this is 1 by n. So bounded times another function, 1 by n goes to 0, so the whole thing will go to 0. So what is the limit function here? The limit function is 0. So if I define a function f from R to R by fx is 0 for every point in the domain. So then fn converges to f pointwise. Yeah. Do you agree with me now? So your task will be this. You will see in MAPA, in the chapter sequence of functions, the second page and third page is completely based on finding the point wise limit. So you please, like, some of the questions I have done already here. As you can see, this we have done this and all, right? So what your task will be? You take each questions from that example. There are 8 or 9 questions, or possibly 10. You try to find the point-wise limit for every sequence of functions. If you are facing any problem to find the point-wise limit to any of that function, why we are doing that way and anything else, you please ask me in the next class. I will clear your doubts and then I'll start with uniform convergence. So please do that. I have next class after a week, I guess, this is 7 or maybe after 2-3 days. So you have enough time, you find the point-wise limit. See, before studying the uniform convergence, you must be clear with the point-wise convergence. So unless you don't know how to find the point-wise limit, you cannot talk about uniform convergence. So what you do, you please take all the examples, do try to find the point-wise limit by yourself. If you are stuck, see the example how they have done. If you are having trouble that why they have done this way, you ask me, I'll clear your doubts. So that's all for today from my side. If you have any confusion in today's class, feel free to ask. Thank you.